Hey guys, it's Brandon, and welcome to my lesson on Watching the Bottom Fall by Love and Death. In the description, you will find a link to some tabs. This song is tuned to drop A flat, or if you prefer, G sharp. For the first six strings, I'm tuned to D sharp standard. For the seventh string, so if you have a seventh string or whatever, or a sixth string, you would basically be tuned to the G sharp. And for you eighth string players, I'll show you why later, but we're gonna tune the eighth string to a G. So here is the opening riff. That is played twice for the opening riff. So basically what I'm doing is I'm alternating the open one, on the low G sharp note. And then the octave higher is up here on the D sharp string. Then when I play the fifth fret, and then this is where it changes a little bit. So this is on the D sharp string, 5, 6, 4. And then it does the same thing over again. The change is whenever the riff is doing the turnaround, you play more of the power chord, the drop, you know, power chord style, 3, 6, 1. So up to full speed, it would sound like this. And then during the verse, the guitars start to kick back in. I'll play it slower now. Notice how I'm stopping by, you know, resting my back of my hand basically on the strings. If you have the eighth string, you're gonna sound like this. If you have anything different than this eighth string, probably the easiest thing to do is to do this instead. So 4, 5, 7. And if you're playing on an eighth string, you're gonna do open 1, open 3. So whatever you do, you play that riff twice. And then you go to the pre-chorus. So in the pre-chorus, what I do, just to make it a little bit different, instead of playing an actual power chord on the eighth, I just play the one string. It just sounds kind of cool. That's on the low G sharp. I'm going 8 and 5. So it's just like, it's not even really a pre-chorus. It's just a little, you know, a little tiny bridge to the chorus, because after this, the chorus drops. So you're going to do open. Then do 5, 3, and then 1, and then open again. And then after that open, you go 5, 8, 1. It repeats itself after that. Open 5, 3, 1, open 5, 8, 1. Then after that, we go back to the main riff. This time you don't play it twice, you just play it one time. So as soon as you hit that 3, 6, 1, then you go back to the second verse. And what's cool is the second verse is exactly like the first verse. And then after that, you go to the pre-chorus hook thing where you go, and then the chorus all over again. So up to this point, you've got all the way up to the bridge because their song is exactly the same. And again, you know, you can use my demo for reference if you want to, or the tabs for reference. So then after the second chorus, they go to this long pause, and then you hear the drums, and then, you know, it stops for a second, and then, you know, boom, you've got the bridge. As that is ringing out, let it ring, and then go up to D sharp, and then, you know, the fifth fret, and then you get the octave. and then, you know, low G if you want, or, you know, 8th string, I'll go. And while that's, of course, ringing out, hit the 4. So the easiest way that I remembered on my 8th string was, okay, I've got the open stuff, and in between the open stuff, I've got 5, 4, 5, and then the second time I hit 4, it's a little bit different, and I'll show you how. Let me go ahead and show you what that's gonna sound like. And then this is where it changes. It goes 4 open, 4 5, and then it does the thing all over again, except it cuts off at the very end, and I'll show you what I mean. So it stops just like that. Everything, the whole band stops, and then it goes back to the chorus. After the chorus, they do the main riff again. If you have any questions about anything at all, especially this lesson, please leave those in the comments below, and I will definitely get back to you and help you any way I can. If you like what you see, please make sure to hit that subscribe button. And if you want to keep watching more of my videos, I have included some here on the side that I thought you might like to see. I hope I will see all of you next time. Thank you.